Hey, Dill.
Hey, Matson.
How you doing, man?
Good, buddy.
Good to see you.
As always.
God, how many years are we doing this now?
I've lost track, but it's more than I care to remember. It's always fun.
Hey, Matson Breakey here, Dill Albright. We're here. It's the 2018.
Yes.
I resolved to get to
Jeep.
Jeep, yes. The I resolved to Jeep giveaway here with MetalCloak Live. It's been a while. I mean, we always try to do MetalCloak Live more than once a year, but it seems like with everything happening last year,
yeah,
we don't really just get one done. You were busy all year.
Between the land use stuff and your business changing and growing that we'll talk about, it's been a heck of a year.
It has been one heck of a year. 2017 was a great one. Well, hey, for those of you just joining us there, this is the 2018 I Resolve the Jeep giveaway, MetalCloak Live, and we're here in our fancy studio. We'll talk a little bit about that.
Nice.
With the new building and all that happening. And basically, we're here just to give away some stuff and to get some updates, talk about 2017, about land use, about what we've done in the world of Jeeping, about the JL Wrangler and some cool stuff happening there. That's like the big thing everybody has been talking about pretty much all of last year. And all kinds of other stuff. And, of course, giveaway prizes. That's the big thing.
Give away lots of prizes.
We've got quite a few entries from this time. For those of you who went through the process and, you know, doing this particular giveaway is a little bit harder. It takes a lot of effort and dedication. But the great thing about that is only those who really want to do it, do it. You don't have a bunch of people just entering just to enter. And so the odds are a lot greater for those 200, and I think it was this year, 210 entries.
Right.
Of those 210 entries, odds are going to be really great that you're actually going to win something.
Well, it's a fair process. You have certain rules on certain steps, and the folks that went through them are going to win some stuff, hopefully.
Absolutely. So here's the basic rules for the I Resolve the Jeep giveaway. If you went through the steps at iresolvethejeep.com and follow those through exactly, then you are in this folder. This folder contains all the entries. Every one of those entries is numbered from 1 to 210. We have a random number generator here on the phone. We'll go to that and we'll let the phone decide who those winners are for the third place, second place, and first place winners, which we will do throughout the show. During the show, we will also go through and just out of fun start giving away some stuff. We've got some cool little things. We've got, you may have seen the Sidekick Off-Road 2018 calendar. We'll be giving away a few of those. We have our line of cloaked Republic shirts, which includes one of my favorites, which is the thin blue line shirt. Mm-hmm. You know, we got that. Mm-hmm. We've got all kinds of stuff, including what we gave our employees this year. You know, every year at Christmas time, we do something special.
Sure.
It was a backpack one year, last year jackets. This year, these soft-sided coolers we did for our employees. So we got a bunch of these. We'll be giving away a few of those today.
Nice.
And if you don't win them there, I think they're going to be going up on the website for as a limited edition item.
Like it.
Yeah, same company that makes the Bad Pack, Odeo. Very nice thing. So we'll be doing a few of that throughout the show. And Dell will be doing all the choosing simply because he's the unbiased participant. But
I don't get to win.
Dell, you're a winner every day.
Thank you. Thank you, Matson. That was
so
nice.
So part of this is just, and I think the very first thing is to really get into what I know I've always interested in, because this is when I learn about it as well. A lot of times Dell's out, and this year he spent a lot of time across the country. He went to a lot of different events. And just give us a sense, give us an idea. In the world of land use, was 2017 a winning year?
We had some wins. If it's okay, I'd just like to say a word about Kevin.
Oh, yeah. Please.
We started a little bit on the sad side, but the news isn't all bad. Really good friend of ours, a hero, Wheelers for the Wounded, Rubicon Trail Foundation, Blue Ribbon, Cal 4-Wheel, this guy does it all. Kevin Carey had a stroke on December 6th, massive stroke, and has been in the hospital until just this weekend, came home,
wow,
and he's recovering, but we're tipping our hat to Kevin and bringing down some chop, so wishing him well. He's one of my land use guys, too. He's helped us a lot. You've been involved with him. So,
yeah,
here to you, Kevin.
Kevin's been around a long time. He was one of the original founders of Pirate, wasn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
The club itself.
Right,
you know, right. Pirates of the Rubicon. And he helped me from the beginning with Friends of the Rubicon. Mm-hmm. So, been around.
Yes.
We're wishing him a full recovery. Right now, he's not taking visitors yet, but he's coming back. So.
Good. Well, we know he will. And our prayers are out for him. And
you bet.
You know, it's definitely been a year for that. There's been a few friends in the off-road industry that have had some health issues this year. And,
yeah.
But let's all remember that what we're out here fighting for is not only land use itself, but really, you know, our ability to enjoy it while we have our sight to enjoy it.
That's one of the main messages I've delivered over the past year, you know, besides join and keep our trails open, the fact that if you get a chance to get outside, do it. Take the kids, take mom, the dog, whatever, get outside and enjoy that Jeep and have some fun when you can afford it and every chance you can, because you just never know. Kevin was a shock. So yeah. On the other side, I just got a note the other day that five bills have been introduced in the House Natural Resources Committee and politics in Washington, D.C. to change and revamp the Endangered Species Act.
Oh, really?
Simplify it.
Wow.
Get rid of some of the restrictions, which for Deer Valley Trail, not the Rubicon so much, but Deer Valley, Strawberry, some of our local California trails, bugs and critters have been a problem, apparently.
Apparently.
Most of it turned out to be not a problem, but they're revamping it. And when you hear the administration shrinking national monuments and coming back to some common sense approach, to me, that's a big win.
Wow.
That's a step in the right direction of keeping our access open.
Right.
To me, that's important. So.
Well, that's what it's all about, too. And we're seeing a lot of changes happening. And I know the current administration in D.C. has been pushing it and pushing it and really coming to terms with things that many administrations have been saying that they are willing to do.
Right.
But never actually done. Right. So whether... No matter what side of the coin you're on when it comes to politics, ultimately, in this lifestyle that we have,
right,
we need to have access to those lands. And we need to be good caretakers of those lands as well, because it's going out there and not taking care of the land and destroying the land you're using that creates the momentum for them to be able to close it on us.
Whether you're just a modern Jeeper, a MetalCloak's Owners Club, or just a Jeeper, setting that example, doing it right,
right,
having fun. I'm not saying don't have fun. And if you got skinny pedal and you want to use it, do it right. But have fun. But remember, there's somebody always watching. So the better we do it, the more we follow the rules, the more we'll be able to do it in the future.
Right, right. So I know we're having a little bit of technical difficulty on the YouTube side. There seems to be some, you know, some people will not be able to see it on YouTube live, but you can still watch it on Facebook. So hopefully if you're all watching on Facebook, spread the word. But it is working on YouTube.
It's just the link that was given for some reason is not working.
So it didn't go live on MetalCloak Live.
It is live on YouTube.
Okay. So if you can find it live on YouTube, it's there. But if you go to MetalCloakLive.com, the event that we set up is not the one that's streaming. So should be able to find it. It is on YouTube, but the event we set up at MetalCloakLive.com is not the one that's streaming right now. So.
And Gary put up a link in the YouTube feed.
There's several links in there.
Okay, good. So just follow the links that are set up there, and you'll be able to go and see it on YouTube live. Either way, if you're on YouTube, I'm monitoring the comments. If you're on Facebook, I'm not monitoring the comments right now. So we're not monitoring those, but I have the YouTube comments here. So either way, we're just happy you're watching. That's why we did multiple streaming options. And that's why we're always working it out on technology. But
and this is a brave thing. Matson and Dell going live. Come on.
That's all to look for. You know, so back to it. I mean, that really is why we're out here doing it. I mean, we always like to say, if we don't have trails to wheel on, we don't have a reason to have vehicles. If we don't have a reason to have vehicles, there's no reason for us to be in business.
Right.
You know, we're very blessed to have the opportunity to be able to every day live this life. You know, at MetalCloak, we've been pretty successful making some products that customers enjoy, and that's really a great blessing. And
in fact, Matson and I were out, it's been a couple of years ago, but we had our Jeeps up on the Rubicon Trail, and we just decided to pull over on this. It's not even an official spot, just a spot where we could stop and kind of get a good picture or two. And we stood there. It was a beautiful day, blue sky, and we were on the Rubicon. There was hardly anybody around. I think must have been a business trip for us, just checking some product out. And it was, we stood there and went, this is why we do this.
Right.
I mean, we stepped out of the Jeeps. Somebody got some good shots of us, of course.
Right, right.
But yeah, it was awesome. That's why we do it.
That's right. It's that enjoyment. You know, you've been out in the, you know, the wilderness has been part of your life forever. I know that half the time when I can't get a hold of you, you're out fishing or hunting or something.
Working.
Working, right.
Yes.
Right, you're out working. Right?
Yes.
Which, of course, you got to tell us your old hunting story in 2017. That was a great land use moment.
It was a land use moment, yeah. I got to go to Colorado this year for a big deer hunting trip, and first time in a lot of years I've been out of state. It was absolutely, went with my hunting buddy, my cousin Steve. Matson knows cousin Steve. Uh-oh, yeah. Choking up. So, anyway.
I've been fighting a cold now, all of a sudden it hits me.
Go ahead. We had a spectacular time. Some of the greatest views and vistas, high desert in western Colorado. It was just a wonderful trip. And yes, we brought home some venison, and it was an incredible journey. And part of that was having access. I mean, I come back to that all the time, because whether I'm fishing, hunting, jeeping, doesn't matter. It's all about access. In fact, when we started the Friends of the Rubicon, 2001, our motto was kind of like, it's not just the Rubicon, it's access. Because we were setting an example for right. other trails and other people to follow how to keep it open.
Right.
It's about the access. So that was, and the hunting trip just capped it off, ribbon on the package for me.
Yeah, that's great.
Do I need to carry this while you choke up, Matthew? Yeah, so Paul right here, I'm with the Blue Ribbon Coalition, now known as sharetrails.org.
Tell us about that.
Share Trails has always been our website, and we decided to adopt that name because it just makes more sense. I mean, we'll always have that Blue Ribbon Coalition, mm-hmm. but sharing trails, sharetrails.org, is really what we do.
Right.
And matter of fact, one of the things we're talking about now are e-bikes.
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 Right. Wow.
It's coming on. People are buying them and taking them out.
Uh-huh.
They don't qualify as an ATV, a dirt bike, or
they're, so they don't really have a designation.
Electric,
yet.
Yeah, e-bike. So
wow.
we're dealing with that now to help share the trails with mm-hmm. those kind of users.
Okay.
Everybody should have access.
Right.
And maybe not the same day in the same place as my Jeep, but maybe so. But well, everybody deserves a trail.
Well, and that's what it's all about. I mean, you're right. Everybody deserves a trail, and this is everybody. I don't care if you're a backpacker
yes.
or a jeeper. We're all out there to enjoy ourselves. You've gone on the Rubicon Trail and had backpackers coming through or bikers and other different types going through. It's great. It's beautiful. We want to share it with everybody. You know, we're not trying to say it's ours or it's yours.
Mm-hmm.
What bothers us is when these policies come down and say, well, no, now we're going to close it off to anybody except on foot or llama.
Yeah.
Right? And that just doesn't really let everybody enjoy it the way
it was intended.
It was intended.
Yes, our forefathers didn't fight for this country and our freedoms to have restrictions like that imposed upon us.
Right. So, but to round it up, 2017 was a good year?
Good year.
Fantastic.
Good year.
Because there have been some years we've come through and just shaking our heads going, what are we going to do?
Well, we were doing this show way back when we were fighting for the hammers.
Right. That's right.
Huge battle. 22,000 letters.
Yeah.
And, you know, everybody invested all of their land use time to save the hammers,
because right.
a lot of you love the hammers.
Absolutely.
And it's coming up, King of the Hammers, next month.
Just a couple of weeks away, isn't it?
Yeah, wow. yeah. That's
Gosh.
Right.
Yeah, it's only a few weeks away. It's crazy. You know, part of that as well, obviously, MetalCloak, we're a big supporter of King of the Hammers and Ultra 4 Racing, and we'll be down there. It looks like we're still working out some details. We might actually be able to have the CTI trailer down there.
Oh.
And have people come out and do some CTIs. We're still working out details on it. It's kind of last minute, but we need some cooperation from some other partners and to make that happen.
Everybody watching probably knows the CTI, but if you've never experienced the corner travel, the change in your Jeep sitting on that trailer with all those hydraulics going on, it really shows you what your Jeep can do and maybe what it could do better.
Right.
I mean, it's a firsthand, it's an amazing visual.
Well, that's the idea. Yeah, that's the idea, is that we can sit there and show it and be able to help people out. So that kind of brings up one of the things we're actually going to talk about is the tour next year, or this year, 2018. But, you know, we've been at this for about 15 minutes. I think it's time to give away some stuff, all right?
Cool.
So first, let's start out big. Let's give away one of these soft-sided coolers. All right, so just randomly choose somebody in there.
Just random?
Just randomly choose somebody.
And Del Albright wouldn't work, right?
How about Adam Albers? Adam Albers.
Adam Albers. Adam Albers. All right. Adam Albers, you got yourself a soft-sided cooler. Now, to get it, you got to send us a message via Facebook saying, hey, I'm here, I won, thanks a lot, and make sure to include your address with you. We'll get that sent out to you.
That's a BA12JK on his handle.
Yeah, his handle over there.
Adam Albers.
At moderngperform.com. And let's do something else, too. Let's give away a calendar. Our 2018. Now, the crew that's doing all the film work is also our graphic design crew that put this together. Yes, did an awesome job. This is the fourth year. Is this the fourth year we've done the calendar?
I think so.
Yeah, about the fourth year. You know, this is almost like 29 years this calendar has been around. And Rick Russell started this Sidekick Off-Road. Several years ago, he was ready to retire and put it aside, and we decided to take it on and keep going. So we kept it going, and it's been great. And so I think it's our fourth year doing it. It goes under the Modern Jeeper badge, and it's just got some beautiful imagery in there, some great sponsors and supporters. Currently available on the website for 50% off.
And you have events in there.
That's like the big thing. Throughout here are listed off-road events from around the country, the major events and minor events too. And if you've got a club and you haven't submitted to us your events, well, shame on you, because we'll put them in here. Even your smallest club event will go in this calendar so that everybody can know about it and help you grow your events and support your organization and the stuff you do. So let's give away one of these.
James Luring.
James.
Known as Boosnark?
Boosnark.
Boosnark.
James Luring. James Luring. Okay, congratulations. You got yourself a calendar. Awesome. We'll do a little more giveaways. But now since we're doing a 45-minute show and we're 15 minutes into it, we should probably give away one of the big ones, okay? So now, again, this is for the three items that you were to put on to your I Resolve the Jeep giveaway. What we're doing is the order. We'll do the number three item, choose somebody who did that, number two item, number one item. If you've already won one of these other items, it doesn't disqualify you from the main prizes, okay? So we're going to do that. Now, we went through, and if you didn't follow the rules precisely, we either removed you from the entry, disqualified you, or if it was simply like one of your items, because one of the more common ones, and it's very much spelled out in the rules, is you can't just say, I want a full overlying system for my JK. You had to specify the individual parts, front fenders, rear fenders, rockers. So if you did, we deleted that from your entries, but your other entries that qualified were left. So everybody has an equal opportunity to win. So we have from 1 to 210. We're going to hit the randomize button here. And 163.
Missed the one. 163 is Michael Stabley.
Michael Stabley. What's his user ID?
Stabes82.
Michael Stabley. Congratulations. You've won. What does it say?
A number three?
Yeah.
He won all that?
Yeah.
JK Wrangler lock and load, long arm, compound suspension, 4.5 to 5.5, and Rocksport LT.
Rocksport. Oh my God. So you got it right out of the box. A JK Wrangler, lock and load, long arm compound suspension, your choice of 4.5 or 5.5 inch, Rocksport Long Travel Shock Edition. Congratulations, nice. Michael.
Right
got
on.
Yourself a,
yeah.
One of our top of line suspension systems. Awesome. Great job. So, that one's cool, man. That's great.
That's right. A giveaway right off the bat.
Oh, I know. We've had years we haven't given away at a suspension at all. And now we're like right out of the bat giving one of the top suspensions away. That's awesome.
Nice job.
Now, what's interesting is he did six-pack edition, variation of six-pack edition, and then Rocksport edition for his first, second, and third. So he knew he wanted a suspension.
Yep.
All right, Michael. So, Michael, you've got until the end of the show to send us a message via Facebook confirming that you heard this and, you know, getting a hold of us, all right? So until the end of the show. So don't miss out on that suspension.
Cool.
If you know Michael, maybe you should reach out to him. All right. So, land use, so things are going well in 2017. Things are going well for you. You did a lot of events this year.
Well, and, you know, I was going to mention, too, I was just bragging on the Outstanding Trails program from Bill Goodrich Tires.
Oh, right.
They just gave
away one of our partners, too.
Four trails this year, got a $5,000 grant. And to me, when they put money behind their mouth, that makes a difference for me.
Right, right.
And BFG, if you've ever done Colorado, Chinaman Gulch, Elephant Hill down by Moab, south of Moab, Grizzly Lake, St. Elmo up in Colorado again, and the Purrington Creek Trail in Alaska, all got $5,000.
Wow.
Outstanding trails, which means they're going to, you know, maintenance, repairs, signage,
so,
and take care of it. And BF Goodrich hands them a check.
So, okay, so the Outstanding Trails, so how does somebody, or how does BFG decide the Outstanding Trails? Is it purely a grant process, or?
We have an off-road four-wheel community
of
judges.
Okay.
The rumor has it I might be one, but there's judges in there, and we take each grant application, sort it out, sift through it, follow up questions, do the analysis, and decide who really will put that money to good use.
Oh, wow.
And they get a grant. It's pretty simple. It's fair. I received one back a long time ago for the Rubicon course. And when you get $5,000 as a club,
oh yeah,
that's a nice chunk of money to go do signs and repairs, rent some tools, buy some food.
Right.
If it keeps that trail open, BF Goodrich Tires stands behind it and says, go do it. And I just checked the numbers. Program's been around 12 years. And they've given out $160,000 to clubs.
Wow.
So that's
We're proud to have BFG as one of our partners and supporters of not only the CTI Tour 2018, and they were part of 2017. The calendar, they've helped support the calendar going out.
Yeah.
And just been all around great company to be involved with. And great. And I think it was actually, you know, it was an introduction from Dell that they introduced us to BFG as a great partner.
Yeah, you know, when there's a lot of products out there, a lot of good tires, but when somebody puts money behind what they believe in and the sport, land use in my case, like BF Goodrich Tires, I'm on the team with them. I mean, they're helping. In fact, I'm going to head south here in a couple of weeks to work with some people on the launch of a new KM3 coming out.
Ooh. You get to be on that launch. That's nice.
Yes. So the new Mud Terrain, KM3, is going to hit the streets, and it's an amazing tire. Wait till you see the reviews. So, are we giving?
Let's see here. Yeah, I'm just doing a little bit. I'm checking. A lot of people saying, because they're going to MetalCloakLive.com, referring people over to Facebook. So apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. It is on YouTube, just not at MetalCloakLive.com. But if you're watching on Facebook, that's great. You can do that, and you can find it on YouTube. And right now, I'm just monitoring the MetalCloakLive.com page so that I can continue to answer any questions you may have, seeing what we can get for you. But next, let's go ahead and give away another one of these bags.
Oh, you have more than one?
Oh yeah, we got more than one.
Can I just pick a number here?
Yeah, just pick. Just choose one out.
How about Ken Ryder, number 152, Ken Ryder.
Ken Ryder.
Rubikin.
Rubikin, nice. So congratulations, Ken. You got another one of our soft-sided MetalCloak special 12-pack coolers. All right, and how about a shirt? Let's give away a shirt. The only caveat on these shirts that we have under the Cloaked Republic brand, which you can see, is that we do not make them in 3X because we found the 3X was actually too short. So if you're a 3Xer and you win one of these, you could choose one of our other shirts instead that are in 3X. But any of the Cloaked Republic brand shirts are only go up to 2X in size. Well, let's give away one of these thin blue line shirts.
Terry Van Beek, T-Berry 656, Terry Van Beek.
Terry Van Beek. All right, got until the end of the show, send us a message. You got yourself a T-shirt. Congratulations. Again, if you're winning one of these, it does not disqualify you from the main prize. So, JL, the JL Wrangler. You know, 2017 was a lot of following for the JL. I mean, we were all looking and exciting. At ModernJeeper.com, which is our online magazine, that covers more than just MetalCloak. It's a great magazine. We are always working to put more update on it. But for a long time, the most popular posts were the latest picks of the JL Wrangler.
Yeah.
Those stock picks. Have you actually had a chance to see it up close yet?
Yeah.
Yeah? What do you think?
It's beautiful.
Yeah? Yeah.
Yeah. I'd love to have one.
So you've heard it here first. If you have nothing better to do, Dell Albright is looking for a donation of a JL Wrangler.
It's going to be called GoFundDell.com.
GoFundDell.com. Yeah. He will put your name big and bold on the side.
Yes.
Absolutely. And he promises not to just make it a sticker whore car.
I think that Joe, a lot of people, really, the ultimate of what a Jeep can do, mm-hmm. right out of the factory. I mean, Mopar, Jeep has really gone overboard with this baby. It is engineered to a T. I think you'll be doing trails you couldn't even imagine in a stock vehicle with this JL.
Well,
and
you know,
add a few goodies to it, then you really get serious.
Right. And you know, we've already heard some companies are like, oh, we're going to be the first out of the box with stuff, right? And we're supposed to be getting ours most likely this week.
Nice.
We ordered a four-door red Rubicon, and we're looking at being able to get it. It was being shipped last Sunday, so it's probably... Where we're out here, they get shipped over to Benicia. And we understand it's probably sitting in Benicia right now, in which case it'll get expedited over here, and we should have ours this week. So we're excited to get our hands on it and start tearing it apart. But one of the things we've determined we're going to do is not approach it as if it's a modified JK. And we've seen a lot of that, like, hey, it's a modified JK. It's not that different. We're going to find a way to make our parts work for it, right? And some bumper company came out with like the first ever bumper for it, and really it's just a modified JK bumper. And there's some other companies that are like modifying their parts and getting them on there, and that's not our goal. Mm-hmm. We're going to approach it as if we did with the JK from the ground up. We have a whole slew of engineering specs to get from it, learn about it from the ground up, and really learn if what we currently have and we offer on the JK suspension is what the JL needs, and develop products specifically for it, and be able to really engineer it right. We don't want to engineer it first, we want to engineer it right.
Right, that's important. I think a lot of the viewers already know this, but when something comes out of the factory, doesn't matter what vehicle, what brand, it might be a great vehicle, but when you start doing what we do with it, and some of the variations we take on, there's always room for improvement. There's always room for a little better armor. There's always room for suspension mods. And that's where doing it right will be important right here at MetalCloak's.
Right. And that's the thing, is we want to be able to look at it. And what does it really need? What benefits can we really give it? You know, there's a lot of stuff out there now you see for the JK that is purely, I think, non-functional is the nicest way to put it, right? And it's because it's trying to take it to the next level, a little more different look to it. And we've always been function first. You know, from our fenders to our bumpers to our suspension, it's function first, and giving you the best possible experience with the product. So we'll be doing it. You know, we do have some targets and goals for events this year where we want to be able to roll out product at those shows. But we're going to take our time and make sure that it's done right and done.
To me, that's worth every waiting moment. If it's done right, I don't have to redo it.
Exactly.
That's perfect.
That's the idea.
MetalCloak exceeds your expectations.
Ooh.
Hey.
Meeting your needs and exceeding your expectations.
That's right.
So where are we at? 3:30. I think, yeah, let's give away another something. Let's give away another shirt.
Another shirt?
Another shirt.
Dustin Khanna, the wild one.
Dustin Khanna. Congratulations. Let us know what shirt you want and what size via Facebook by the end of the show. Appreciate it, my friend. All right. It is about that time, but before we give away the next prize, which will be the number 2, what do you think of the new building?
You know what? I've got to tour this new facility here at MetalCloak a couple of times now. And what I'm seeing is the importance, the organization, the systematization.
Ooh, that's quite a word.
That's quite a word. The systematization, where things are situated to fit the need of production, manufacturing, shipping. It just makes sense. I've been around this business for a lot of years. This makes sense, besides the plush little cubicle that I can now work in when I come to visit. That's not so plush, but it's okay. Now, this This is a facility that's going to take MetalCloak into the future. I'm impressed. I like it.
Well, I appreciate that. We, you know, it's taken a lot of work. We're still, many of you have been asking for a chance to get a tour of it, you know, a virtual tour. And we're still putting things together. Like anything, it's always a constant evolution to make sure. You know, we started out in 2,000 square feet back in
2008 or something.
January 5th, 2009. Economy's going to shit, excuse my language. And we were starting a business, and it was a lot of fun. Now we're in 70,000 square feet, and it's a lot more comfortable, because at a certain point at that last building, which was 45,000 square feet, it was a little crowded.
Yes.
It was a little tight in there.
In fact, I've talked to two clubs that are arranging to come and visit.
Yeah, we got a club.
The Sierra Foothills Overlanders is right. One of the clubs I just met with. They want to come visit.
And, well, that's a great thing about it. Some stuff we'll be showing you when we do get a chance to do tours. We have a great break room and a facility, and we're offering that up. Like, local clubs can actually come and do club events here, club meetings. We have a great board room for different groups to be able to come and have board meetings at.
Yeah.
And it's just a number of things that we can do here, plus a great parking lot to be able to do show and shines.
Well, and the blending with Cloakworks 4x4.
Right.
And their operation out there is significant.
Right.
You have room for them. There's a line of Jeeps in there all getting upgrades and modifications. In fact, my little Jeep is in there right now getting a few fixes done and some upgrades. So this is working well. I see this into the future for you quite nicely.
Well, let's appreciate that. That's kind of the game here. It's the idea that we can be able to grow and be able to do things and meet the needs. You know, we're still, and I'll be the first to apologize, we're still delayed right now on some product, especially on the body armor side, and it wasn't from the move, surprisingly. We actually did a great job of moving rather
fast.
Seamlessly.
Yeah.
I know our sales department was only down for an hour. That's how quick we were able to get from the old building to the new building, get set up and not have any downtime, and we weren't down on production hardly at all. The challenge we had was actually having just a demand at the end of the year that was unprecedented for us. We had not expected that much demand. And we're not the type of company to say, hey, here's a lot of demand, let's go and hire a bunch of people to meet the demand that I'm gonna lay them off after the holidays. We decided we're gonna work as hard, and our team has been working 10-hour days, 12-hour days, getting that overtime and pushing through to meet that demand and make sure that all of you. So we're getting caught up here, and we appreciate those who have had the patience to work with us. When your orders are delayed from our usual 1 to 2 weeks to 2 to 3 weeks or more. Mm-hmm. But all that's been coming through. But this facility has been great, and that's part of it, being able to learn the facility better and work out our promotional systems. And having a little studio like this.
This is nice.
Because there's a really cool logo back here, but that really cool logo, in a moment's notice, can disappear and be a nice green screen, which is kind of cool. But we like it. The guys have done a great job here of setting this up and making an incredible little studio for us to do this stuff in.
It's
fun.
David Letterman and Johnny Carson right here. Just, we got the lights and everything.
Wait, which were you?
So, you know, so, can I do one more land use thing?
Yes.
I just got noticed, you've probably seen it, I have a Facebook group now that's just about land use, volunteerism, and training and leadership. It's growing by leaps and bounds. A lot of people get involved. But one of the things that just came across our radar is a change in the NEPA process, the National Environmental Policy Act, a simplification of that, and the permit process. A lot of clubs are getting hit with the need to have a permit to go take 20 Jeeps and go on a ride.
Mm-hmm.
Not the Rubicon, because that's a county road.
Right.
But other places, BLM and the Forest Service are looking to beef up their bank accounts and permit events.
Right.
Which will kill a club.
Right.
Because it takes 6 months to a year to get a permit and a lot of paperwork. Well, now this whole process is under revision. Blue Ribbon Cult Share Trails, a lot of organizations have been pounding on their desks to simplify this. So if we want to have a customer appreciation run someplace that isn't readily available, we can get a permit in a short period of time and a reasonable amount of paperwork. That'll help us a lot. So
right.
That's good news.
Yeah.
We've been fighting that for years.
Well, it is. And there's a lot of stuff happening on that front that's pretty amazing. But it's the result of some organizations and some governmental agencies getting a little overbearing.
Right.
There have been horror stories about trying to get permits from certain groups.
Yes.
That where it's 18 months out. And I don't know about you.
Yep.
I don't know about you, but I can't plan 3 months out, let alone try to plan something that far out.
A year out is not uncommon in California, especially. Now, the other good news in California, the OHV program, the state parks, our entire off-road motor vehicle division, the grants, the prairie cities of the world, state parks now is a permanent fixture, permanent part of the state parks is the OHV division. So it's been permitized.
Permitized.
Systematized and permitized. This is really good news. So the grants, my partner Don Amador at Blue Ribbon, he just went to the grant workshops, said 200 people filled the room looking for clubs and grants and different forests.
Wow.
Yes. Amazing. Wow. Because we think, A, now it's permanent.
Yeah.
It has no longer been swept under the rug. Right. It has a valuable position now. So in California especially, the grant process is going to get even better.
Wow.
So that's and California Association of Four-Wheel Drive Clubs and some others have really held up their end of the deal on this one.
That's awesome. That's great. Well, that's good news for California especially. Especially on the West Coast, because we always have,
yeah,
you know, we forget that some people on the East Coast have already lost their trails.
And they know it.
They know it. And so out here in California, the West Coast, we're still trying to save that. We're still trying to save, make sure we don't lose Moab. Make sure we don't lose California. Make sure we don't lose Nevada. Hey, let's give away that big second place prize, okay? So this will be a random number generator moment for number 1 to 210. 163 was our last winner. Now we're hitting the button. 26. Whoa. Wow, we went up to 26. 26 is the number. 26. Who is that?
Darren Griswold.
Darren Griswold.
The Grizz.
D-Grizz. Darren Griswold. Congratulations. What was his number 2 item listed? Uh-oh, Darren. Sorry, buddy.
Bad.
Your number 2 item was removed because it didn't follow guidelines. Sorry, big boy. We got to choose another one. No, we already had 163. That already came through. 188. That's funny.
Sonny Garcia.
Sonny Garcia. All right.
Sonny Garcia.
Congratulations, Sonny Garcia. All right. Number 2 item is?
Overland Tube Fenders JK Wrangler Front.
Overland Tube Fenders JK Wrangler Front. Congratulations.
You yourself job.
A set of Overland Tube Fenders with the JK Wrangler Front. You have until the end of the show to reach out to us and give us a comment via Facebook claiming your prize, all right? Again, that is Sonny Garcia.
So Garcia.
So Garcia from ModernGperform.com. All right, congratulations, Sonny. And Darren, was it Darren Griswold? I'm going to send you one of these as a consolation prize, even though you didn't follow the rules, my friend. So that was number 26, I think.
Oh, well, he was back there. Okay.
Yeah. So just mark him down for a soft-sided cooler.
Okay. Oh, there he is. Okay.
Yeah.
Got it.
But we got to be fair to everybody, to those who did follow the rules. All right. That's good. So, now there's a little bit of an announcement that we have to make, and we kind of talked about this. And this is pretty cool. You were talking about getting out and doing events and being able to do a customer appreciation run. Well, for many of you, you know, the Modern Jeeper Forum, moderngeeper.com, is a side project of ours. We've been doing it for a few years, and it's experimentation, learning about things, building things up. You know, and it's not just about MetalCloak. I mean, when we created the name Modern Jeeper, the idea was that we're in a new era. There are Jeepers out there who have never Jeeped before in their life, and they're owning a Jeep for the first time. And while we may be taking our Jeeps up some of the hardest rock climbs we can find, some people are just having a Jeep so they can go camping with. There's a wide variety. So the idea with Modern Jeeper was, no matter what your platform is, no matter what your use is, no matter what your Jeep lifestyle is, it's a place for you to come together, learn about Jeeping, share about that with ModernJeeperForum.com, ModernJeeper.com, where we're sharing industry stories, motorsports, all that kind of stuff, to the Facebook group, Modern Jeeper Group, where you can share and ask stories. These are all part of just this network of people from different backgrounds who are in an unjudgmental world where we can share and learn from each other about Jeeping. In that vein, we decided to create a new event, and we are calling this event Modern Jeeper Adventures.
Cool.
So now this has been in the planning for months now. So we're proud to announce that our very first Modern Jeeper Adventure is going to be Moab, Utah.
Right on.
Of course, Memorial Weekend. So start planning that now. Now here's the deal. There's only 50 spots for Jeeps available. We will be announcing, you'll have to watch us on Facebook, but we will be announcing when registration opens, what the registration fees will be, and all that kind of stuff. There's only going to be spots for 50 Jeeps. But it sounds like it's going to be a pretty cool weekend. Friday night registration, wheeling on Saturday, wheeling on Sunday. Gives you a Monday to, you know, Memorial Week day to head back home, whatever you want to do and travel. With some great stuff happening, not only Saturday night, but Sunday night for closing out. It's just a lot of fun stuff. And all this is being done in cooperation with some partners, including Outlaw Jeep Adventures.
Sure.
There in Moab, who's helping host us on this and allowing us to be able to do this event because they already have the permits in place and stuff for doing this. So that is part of why we're able to come into some place like Moab, bring a bunch of you guys together, and have a great time with some good friends out wheeling and just having a good time with it. So this is Modern Jeeper Adventures. Mark your calendars, Memorial Weekend. Keep an eye out. Within the next week, we're going to have the registration page up and be able to start it. Looks like we're going to be doing a Rubicon event. We got a Moab event scheduled. Everything else is all coming together. We'll keep you informed that we have it. But again, Modern Jeeper Adventures. We'll have a website specifically for it, modernjeeperadventures.com. Already secured the URL. So just a matter now of making it happen. But I'm hoping you'll come out and join us on it.
I'm sure
your schedule permits. And we hope to see you guys out there. But it's exciting to be able to do something like this and be able to bring this.
You know, I think there's quite a future in that. For one thing, people like to gather up. We like trail rides.
Mm-hmm.
We like to share, kick tires in the same body armor and the same parts and pieces. That makes it even better. And if we're all part of a family, Modern Jeeper, there's just a connection there that you just can't get down at the Walmart. I mean, it's special.
That's right, because we're all Modern Jeepers here.
Pick a spot like Moab or the Rubicon or wherever we end up going. Can't go wrong. And there could be time in the evening for refreshments and social time, too.
Oh, that's the whole idea. Get a chance to get together. A little bit of refreshment, right? A
little bit.
So between, this will be head up by Corey Osborne. Now, Corey Osborne is the one who does our CTI tour. Mm-hmm. CTI Tour 2018 is underway. In fact, this weekend, I believe, he's at the Winter Jamboree. That's down in Utah. It's
Utah Four Wheel Drive.
Yeah. It's a Winter 4x4 Jamboree.
Yes,
is this weekend in St. George, Utah. Corey's gonna be there with the CTI trailer. That's the beginning of it. So you know, between all of that with the Modern Jeepers, he's gonna be heading that up. The Modern Jeeper Adventures and our friends in Moab. That's gonna be great. So
I look forward to it.
Yeah, moving on back to MetalCloak Live and get some more stuff. Let's give away more stuff. So let's choose. Give away another shirt. Actually, let's do a hoodie. Just choose a number. Just choose one. Great. Oh, right there, front page.
Sarah Duhone.
You got yourself a hoodie. Bad Wolf, is that her?
Yeah.
That's funny. Bad Wolf.
Sarah Duhone. So she's, what was that, a shirt?
Yes, a hoodie. Actually, a hoodie.
Oh, hoodie. Okay. Okay.
Perfect. So, Sarah, I like your handwriting, by the way.
Thank you.
You come from a generation when they actually taught you how to write.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's a lost art.
Knowing how to write, I know this in this day and age, and you hear it all the time. Well, I just need to text or type or whatever. It's like taking the time to actually teach your kids to write is important.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's penmanship makes a difference. Oh, side note, let's give away to something else. Let's give a beanie away.
Stephen Pascasio.
Morrow
35089.
Beanie. That's right. We're giving away a beanie. Or a MetalCloak beanies, one of our nice fleece beanies.
Okay.
So awesome. So we've got a lot going on. A lot more giveaways to happen. What we're doing, let's see, what we're going to talk about next. We've got LCTI Tour 2018. So if you haven't been to our website, go to our website. There's an event page there. And on that event page is all the details where we're going, all the CTI events we're at. I'm just realizing it's already 3:45. We talk a lot, don't we?
I know, we do.
Yeah. All right. So one more announcement before we do our final draw. Skills Day. So this year on Skills Day. We got two skills days this year.
If you're used to one, it's two this year.
Yeah, we've got two this year. We're doing one in April 21st, and one October 13th. Skillsday.com has a registration right now for the April 21st. You guys have asked for more, so we decided instead of doing it in the middle of the year, we're going to do one in the spring, one in the fall. Right. April 21st, October 13th. But go on to skillsday.com if you want to do it, and we'll be able to go through and get it all set up for registering for Skills Day 2018.
If you're close enough to make one of the Skills Days or both, it's worth doing. I try and make as many as I can every time. It's a new experience, new people, but it's a learning experience. You can't buy it. You can't buy it.
So before we do the final big prize everybody's waiting for, let's give away a gold diff cover.
It's solid gold.
So this is a gold diff cover. This thing here is we only have a very few limited edition of these. Yeah. We have a very few limited edition of these things.
You need to take a selfie with or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I have a feeling that from the laughing that's going off our cameraman, that looked pretty funny. So we got a gold diff covers, Dana 44. We actually have a Dana 44 and a Dana 30. This is for a pair of gold diff covers. So if you have a 30 and a 44, you get a set. If you have two 44s, you get a set. So a pair for gold diff covers. All right? So this is going to be a random look. You just go in there, find something.
Oh, just do it?
Yeah, just do it. Just do it. It's all on you, Dale.
All right. Robin Pena.
Robin Pena.
Z-Armada. Robin Pena.
You get a set of gold diff covers. Fantastic. I can't wait to see what the video looked like with me holding it up, because they were just trying not to laugh back there in the control room. Awesome. So just reach out to us. Let us know what you got. 30 and a 44 or two 44s. We'll get you all set up.
If you're Robin, I hope you're listening and watching. Be sure and send us some pictures. Get them on.
All right. So this is for the final prize, the first place prize for the I Resolve the Jeep 2018 giveaway. All right. We're ready? 188 was the last one. 48.
Ooh.
Number 48.
Douglas Niederberger.
Douglas Niederberger.
Looks like he's a staff sergeant.
Staff Sergeant Douglas Niederberger.
Doug, is that mean you're current military?
That's
Douglas
awesome. Well, congrats.
Niederberger.
If you are or aren't, thank you for serving. Oh, no, Douglas.
Oh, no.
Dude. Your first entry, the one you would have won, was deleted because it wasn't according to the rules. Sorry, my friend. But you know what? Because you're a...
I'm assuming that's Staff Sergeant.
Because you're served, we'll do something for you. Just mark, put a star there, and I'll
a Matson special?
Yeah, just put a star there. But can't do it. All right, we got to do this real quick. We're almost out of time. Actually, we're beyond time. Okay, our guys are over there laughing more and more now.
Get it. What's the number?
18.
Oh. Wow. McKinnon Flannery.
McKinnon Flannery. What is that?
Is that a big Jeep?
Okay.
Looks like he has a 97.
What do we got for his number one? Oil pan skid plate for the 4.0 liter Jeep TJLJ. You won. McKinnon Flannery. That's a heck of a name. McKinnon Flannery. McKinnon Flannery, congratulations. You got your number one prize, your oil pan skid plate. Thank you all for watching. This has been another edition of...
Fun. Of
fun times with Dale and Matson.
MetalCloak Live.
That's right here. The 2018 I Resolve the Jeep giveaway. Dale, thanks as always for joining us. We got to do this more often. We always say that. Now that we have this cool studio, a little more time on our hands, I think we can do that. Thanks again, everybody. And thanks for supporting us. We'll see you on the trails.
See you on the trails.